divided between the cops and the people they are supposed to protect and serve. And one place where this tension crystallizes often is my hometown, New York City. Take the case of George Capsis. He's an 85-year-old man who was riding his bike when a police van pulled into the bike lane right in front of him, which is a traffic violation. The man complained to the officers, and that's when things got heated. Mr. Capsis claims the cops pinned him to the van and ordered him to dismount the bike. He also admits that he slapped one of the cops. In an email, he said that amid the, quote, political deceptions, the arrogance of moneyed power, an irresistible rush of hate welled up, and I slapped him. He said the cop then punched him in the face. He was taken to the emergency room after being booked. Mr. Capsis then filed an excessive force lawsuit against the NYPD. He settled out of court this month for $45,000. And that should be the end of a lousy story where a cop punches an 85-year-old guy in the face. But nope, it gets worse. Because now the cop who punched him is suing Mr. Capsis. He says he was only trying to gently guide the man to the sidewalk and then was slapped out of nowhere by an 85-year-old. He's suing for assault and defamation, saying his name has been besmirched. Now, it definitely needs to be noted that Mr. Capsis made headlines this summer for slapping a senator at a political rally. So clearly the man can be cantankerous. He's not a fan of the establishment, and maybe he gets mad pretty quickly. But come on, NYPD. Are you really going to cut off an 85-year-old on his bike and then punch him in the face and then sue him on top of it? In the tension between cops and the public today, there's some lack of respect for authority on one side and too much abuse of authority on the other. Everyone's all mad at each other, and the rich jerks running the show probably love it. But has it gone so far that the state of our authority today is at a place where New York cops shove old men around and then sue them? If that's the kind of behavior we can expect from them, we should start calling them the NYPD. The New York Pansy Department. Tonight, let's talk about that by following me on Twitter at TheResident.